I was fortunate that my dad was in rallies a lot, and in hill climbs in the 50s. He did a lot of the they're called Red X trials, mobile gas trials, and my dad Eddie did those with his brother, and I think that probably certainly assisted or helped my interest in my own career, you know, to get on with it. I knew it could be done. Dad had done it. It was 1960 that he drove a Volkswagen in a 500-mile race at Phillip Island, and I know and I can remember that he was leading the class, and it was a big deal in those years, the class winners. But the last pit stop, the guys didn't put the petrol cap on properly, and they were standard petrol caps, and the petrol all sloshed out well before it should have been used, and they ran out of petrol, so they didn't win their class. And the team and the reliability is always the most important thing, and unless you got that, you still got nothing. And 1968 was a big year for me. It was the year I got my car license, and I got it on the day I was 18, and it was also a big year because I went in a Round Australia Ampol trial, it was called, with my dad. You know, to go in my first competitive competition with my dad in a rally, I thought it was fantastic. This was well before I started my own career. Then my dad, he did all the driving. He tipped it A over T, I think it's called, and wrote it off. And first time he'd ever damaged the car, and in all his rallying. And so it wasn't to be a, you know, an excellent start. It was just to be a start, though, and I thought, hang on, this is something here. I've got to press on with this. What I actually gained from the Formula V racing was that I demonstrated to myself that I could win races, and that was that's a big thing when you're a young bloke. You're not sure whether you're any good. You may think you're a good guy, but until you start proving it to yourself, you're really nothing. And I then, if you like, was proving it to other people that, hey, I could drive, and I was winning races, and that really led to my career as a professional driver. It wasn't until the 1971 series that I got Mac really together and won heaps of races, and won the Formula Ford Driver to Europe Championship. I had a car from the Elfin Company in South Australia to take to England, but I didn't have an engine. And I went to the Ford Motor Company and they said, oh no, we don't give out engines. And the guy out there said, hey, why don't you give Alan Moffat a ring? So I don't know Alan Moffat, but he was a big hero to me in those days. And so I gave him a ring and I went down, and a little bit of small talk for about 30 seconds. And he says, now, how much do these engines cost? I said, $620. And he picked up his checkbook and wrote out a check. He said, go buy yourself an engine, and I wish you well.
When Larry won his Formula Ford championship, that I'd just won Bathurst, so there were a few people at the Ford Motor Company that were happy to do me a favor. And when I heard that he was struggling a bit at the time, the cost of an engine didn't set me back too much.
By winning the Formula Ford Driver to Europe Championship or Series, that was a pretty solid step of getting into Formula One. I went to this British Brands Hatch track for the World Final, and that was a real eye-opener, because after the first practice session, I looked down the sheets to see where I was, and I was used to looking up the front of the list from my Australian days, and went down page one and page two and page three. I finally got to my name. I was 86th fastest out of a field of 120, and my God, I can't believe this. This is what's happened, you know? And the next practice session, though, I moved up to equal fifth quickest or equal third quickest, I can't remember which. That was a real turning point in my mental approach to the racing. I had to crank myself up to a much higher notch than I'd ever thought I needed to. When I was on the limit in Australia, I was really only driving at 7/10, and it was a real challenge to get up to where the rest of the world was. The good performance I had at Brands Hatch opened a lot of doors immediately, and I had offers of free cars and so on. And I first met Bernie Eccleston in 1973 at the French Grand Prix at Paul Ricard. I got to know Bernie very well, and a vacancy came up in Formula One. He rang me up and said, "Hey, I've got a vacancy here because of, I forget the exact reasons, I think Carlos Reutemann left the team to drive for Ferrari, and there's only three races left in the year, and he wanted to put me in, and I was delighted that he did that, and that's how I got into Formula One with Bernie. But it didn't last because I couldn't hold my drive into the next year because of problems with the sponsorships of, I know Martini and Rossi wanted a name driver. They didn't want an unknown bloke from Australia. They don't even sell Martini and Rossi in Australia. In the end, Bernie had to yield to the pressure because I could not pay any of the bills. I brought no commercial clout with me. It left me out in the cold, so I only had a short stint there.
We'll be right back.